So there's been many crossroads. The first one is probably the most, the one you always remember, you know, the first time you made a hard choice, because it then determines all the other times you're going to make hard choices, because you're going to go back to that first time and think, if it worked then, maybe it can work now. The very first moment was very early on, something like third grade. For the first time, we were assigned, you know, write a story about anything you like. And that feeling of how you could create something that had a beginning, a middle, and an end, that was really exciting. And I remember coming home and saying, I want to be a writer when I grow up. I really have a hard time making choices. This is definitely my Roman side coming out. I put it off until the very last minute. Do I really have to choose? Is it yes or no? Does it have to, is it forever? All of these things. I think there's a part of me that really waits until you have your back against the wall, and then finally you see things clearly. That is unfortunately the only way that I have of really making choices, being last minute and completely forced to do it. But then I make really good choices. The places that I'm obsessed with do have a strong nature, a strong sense of nature in common. There's something about nature that is perfectly threatening somehow. So you feel that there's a sense of danger. So places that have a strong geological formation, I think it helps to put yourself in a state of risk and to see what's going to happen from there. A big part of my family is from Milan, and my grandmother and my grandfather are sort of the people who initiated me into the world of literature. When I moved back to Italy and started coming to Milan, because of course the publishing world is here and the editors are here, just to be back in the world of books was so exciting. There's so many incredible bookstores here. This is one of them, but it's just a place where the tradition of literature, you can really feel that it's alive here. I do think that elegance has nothing to do with formality. And I think that, again, we go back to the idea of freedom, and I think that kind of caustic irreverence of just being able to feel free if you decide to go to a grocery store in your pajamas and that's what makes you feel good, and to be able to inhabit whatever it is you're wearing in a determined moment with grace and a sense of lightness.